killed in the ambush is Dr. Mark Connolly and City Marie, Special City Marie Baldwin. The Army played games in Cindy's Purple Heart, and her killed in action status and Mark's also were taken away. They said that she died from a souvenir M42 bomber. In my investigations over 20 years at full, because Mark was killed in the car, the glass should have gone outward. Rebecca Pulley is still blowing glass from her today, 20 years later. They had an agenda. They didn't want to know if this unit was lost in Iraq trying to catch up to the front. They didn't want anybody to know that the unit was actually ambushed. I had a chance to talk with the radio control officer at Dustoff, one of Cindy's scholarship dances. He told me when they went to the first coordinate, there were two Iraqi APCs on the other side of the dunes. When the second CID investigation came, they told him he was hallucinating. I had a chance to see the first CID investigation, and they said that Mark's laser was either a mine or was hit by an RPG. Two of the unit members saw a trail of smoke from across the dunes where the city was lying behind the front wheel of the British ambulance. Either an RPG or a long rocket. Doesn't sound like an M42 bomber. They encounter our soldiers in Iraq and Afghanistan. But back then, Cindy didn't get any of this. I pulled into the cemetery today with my heart in my throat. She's got to be upstairs smiling. She really has to, because this is phenomenal. Okay, no doubt about it, Cindy Marie Baldwin was a hero. Will I ever forget? Bet your bippy I won't. Will I ever stop? Not until my red blood stops flowing in my body. At that point, I hope somebody picks up the banner and runs with it. She didn't have to go. She had a bad back. Her answer, when told she could stay here in Connecticut, but the unit was going, was I joined the National Guard not to serve my duty. That's a hero. She was told it again in Iraq when the unit was split. After the unit staying in Saudi Arabia, half the unit going into Iraq. She fought hard, made the hog go. One of the girls dropped out from something. Wasn't like that, she'd still be alive today. She'd married, have kids like her sister. Her parents would have a daughter. Her uncles, an aunt, would have a niece. Because she was brought up through patriotism and duty, God, and country, she's not here to me. That makes her a hero. I'd like to thank Cindy Baldwin Ambrose. I'd like to thank the Patriot Guard. I'd like to thank the Honor and Remember runners who ran in today's last 5 miles with the Honor and Remember flag. And at this point, I will turn the ceremony over to Rob Heckler, the state chairman for Honor and Remember. Rob?
Flag. They were here to present this personalized flag to Cindy's parents in honor of her sacrifice and her service to our country. The American flag's design is distinctive and simple.
Valley intact.
But thank you for coming, gentlemen and ladies. The St. John will have you. That takes care of the oh, and the young Marines that are here. We're on the flag line. A big special thank you to the Patriot Guard riders. To 8-10 missions a week, hundreds of missions a year, just like both. Thank you very much. Have a good day, and I'm safe.
Thank you.